Are you here?
Yes, I'm here.
MashaAllah. Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Yeah, go ahead and recite last lesson, inshallah.
Okay. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ar-Rahmanir rahim. Malik yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ihdinas siratal mustaqim. Siratal ladhina an'amta 'alayhim. Ghayril maghdubi 'alayhim waladdallin. Amin. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alif Lam Mim. Dhalikal kitabu la rayba fih, hudan lil muttaqin. Alladhina yu'minuna bil ghaybi wa yuqimuna as-salata wa mimma razaqnahum yunfiqun. والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين.
ما شاء الله جزاك الله خير يا محمد ما شاء الله تبارك الله إن شاء الله everyone say ما شاء الله تبارك الله ما شاء الله تبارك الله ما شاء الله تبارك الله I would like just to comment on the reading for a minute, Brother Hamid.
Sure, Chala. Sheikh,
you are muted.
Sorry. Okay, I just want to comment on the recitation. His tajweed is good, mashallah. His way of recitation also, where he stops and from where starts the in ayah itself is very nice, alhamdulillah. Mashallah, his voice is good, mashallah. And the way Muhammad started memorizing, he started from the back. Then he used to have a new memorization and the revision. As all of our students, they have new memorization and old memorization. So he used to work on both, reciting, like for example, I'll give an example quickly, inshallah. Like if he in Surah Al-Mulk, تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير, then his revision will be from عَمَّ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ. Then he will take from Amma Yatsalun to the end of the Quran. At that time, he will be able to reach in the middle of Juz Qad Sama'. Then he will start again. If he's in Qad Sama', he will start from Al Hashr. And his revision will be going to the end of the Quran. And then you will go up to the beginning of the Quran. So he was doing this effort, mashallah, every day, alhamdulillah, until he reached it to that level. Now Muhammad is starting the revision. Congratulations for the whole Quran. He is a new hafiz. Congratulations for the whole, for the community and for his family and for Muhammad. May Allah bless him. Just want to comment on the, give this comment on the recitation, yeah, alhamdulillah. Please make dua for him, inshallah. Brother Hamid.
That's it from my side. I just wanted to share the program, mashallah. Kids like Brother Muhammad, there are other kids too, boys too, mashallah, they are close. So inshallah, not that far, we, in couple of months, inshallah, we will see another graduate, and they are ready, inshallah. Sheikh, of course, their teacher, he knows better than me. He's listened them from every day. So inshallah, we are making progress now. We are kind of production now, mashallah. We will have our local hafaz from ICEV, inshallah. They can serve the community here locally, inshallah. That's it, Brother Nokib, from my side, inshallah.
If you don't mind, Brother Hamid, would like to request Brother Abdullah's parents if they can say something to the community.
Yeah, inshallah.
Yeah, this is Hamad, so I'm the parent. So this is Hamad. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. And on behalf of my family, I would like to thank you, the ICEV board and our beloved Sheikh and the teachers, especially the Sheikh Hassan Sharif. He is not with us in this masjid anymore, but he did spend a lot of time. And I also would like to thank you, everybody who joined us in that blessed occasion to celebrate with us. And I see the friends and brothers and sisters joining from all over the valley and even from California and Texas, I see them. So thank you everybody for joining and keep us in your duas and may Allah guide us and accept this effort. Thank you.
Amen. So now turn to our new graduate, Brother Abdullah. You want to say something to the new student?
I just want to say thank you to everyone for joining. Thank you everyone for your duas. I want to give a special thanks to Sheikh for being a great teacher, for helping me throughout this journey. And Brother Hamid, Brother Hanif, their great program that they established, it helped me a lot. I was able to memorize because of it, and I was able to finish because of it. And I just want to thank the entire valley, the entire masjid, the entire community for all being supportive and helping.
Jazakumullah khairan. May Allah accept you. Sheikh, now floor to you. So you want to say something to the community, inshallah, and after that we can have a question and answer session.
I would like to say something to Muhammad. Mashallah, Muhammad, you did achieve, alhamdulillah, you reached it to your goal, alhamdulillah, by finishing and memorizing the whole Quran. But you know, the first memorization will be shaking and weak. That's why I recommend it for you to keep going in revision, inshallah. And I promised Muhammad in the masjid today after Jum'ah, if he, inshallah, continue in that level of, mashallah, revision, because he started revision already and he's reciting good, mashallah, reciting large part of recitation with beautiful recitation and focusing, mashallah. So if he continue in that level, inshallah, I will give him ijazatun sanadiyya, because we have two types of ijazas. First type is that to approve the person can read and can teach. Like you trust him on the Mabna al-Quran. Mabna al-Quran means that he's reciting good. He will not make mistakes in the recitation, in reading and recitation. The second ijaza, which is ijaza for memorization with the approving the makharij, the sifat, the tajweed, the level of memorization. And this ijaza will be sanadiyya, means the chain will go to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this will be a great honor for Muhammad and his family. And also he will be a future scholar, can deliver this ijaza to people, inshallah, from him whenever he finds someone qualified to carry this great ijaza, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, this is a great occasion for everybody. Jazakumullah khair, Muhammad. And thank for the family. Jazakumullah khair for the parents and the whole family for their helping and supporting. And especially for tonight, you are bringing great happiness to the community. Barakallahu feek.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Jazakumullah.
Wa jazakumullah. I would like also to say something to our youth, and especially the students in memorization class and the reading class in the school of ICEV. First of all, we'll talk about ICEV because this program is, first of all, belongs to ICEV. Then, of course, we appreciate and thank all the teachers and all the programs in the valleys. Alhamdulillah, we have blessed the community in Arizona. Overall in Arizona, mashallah, we have very active brothers and sisters who are teaching in our masjid and different masajid and giving, mashallah, devoting their life and their effort to help the community and help our youth and our children to get the best education of the Islam, alhamdulillah, and learn the Quran. So we thank everybody. And this advice for our student in ICEV, alhamdulillah, we have this program. As you see, it is very, very vibrated program, and they have a lot of encouragements. I would like to encourage you to take benefit of this program. Take benefit of it and be patient. You know, Brother Muhammad spent 4.5 years memorizing, and his family also were hesitating to put him in Hifz class. And I have similar families right now. Brother Muhammad and his family, Brother Hamid, was hesitating 4 years ago to put his son in memorization program. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened his heart and he accepted my offer at that time. And alhamdulillah, we see the fruit right now. So I'm telling the our community is not that serious or difficult program. It's very easy. Just needs a decision from you, because I have some parents now, when I talk to them, their kids, mashallah, are willing to memorize. They are ready, but they are like hesitating to put them in the Hifz program because of the education or the age. So I'm saying, inshallah, there will not be any problem. And just we need patience and time. As we said, Brother Muhammad took 4.5 years, and Brother Hamid was seeing it today after Jum'ah, that it seems, or he feels, that was yesterday. Yes, it is. Time will run and go quickly, but you have a great fruit. You have a great achievement, inshallah, an accomplishment. You will never, inshallah ta'ala, be down all of your life, inshallah, when you have the Quran, the greatest thing you can get in your life. The other advice is that, as he said, it is never be late. It is not late. And if your kids is old or young, and you decided and he could not work, or so it is not late, you should, inshallah ta'ala, enroll him and or not him or her, and inshallah you will find the fruit. So we have students memorize the Quran when they were 8 years old. We have some students finishing the Quran, mashallah, they finished when they are like Muhammad, 16, 15, that age, around that age, and also 13, 14. We have kids also and youth finish the Quran when they are over 20. And they have some doctors, they finish the Quran when they are over 30. And they have all the people also, they finish memorization, mashallah, when they are old. They have family and they are busy. Just you need to be patient and give time and take it seriously. Of course, you need the help and support from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other advice also that a good program, a good teacher will help you a lot. And I usually remind myself of two great methods. One of them is to make it easy as much as you can with the students. Like, for example, if the student is not ready or making mistakes, yes, I be sometimes strict to help the kids to know the to be on the right track, okay? But at the same times, I don't put pressure on the family or in the kids. So they can, inshallah, love the Quran and love the program. So this number one, that to make it so easy as much as you can, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا جَعْلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ. And the Rasulullah sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَعَثَكُمْ مُيَسِّرِينَ لَا مُعَسِّرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you, means command you and command you to be muyassirin, la muassirin, to facilitate it and make it easy, not to make it difficult. I always remind myself, inshallah, this is a good reminder for each and every teacher, inshallah, especially in American environment. American environment, the children can just lose easily. So we have to use the wisdom and be patient and inshallah ta'ala, make it easy on the children. If the child cannot finish in 2 years, give him one more year. If cannot finish in 3 years, give him another 1 year to be four. Make it 5 years, but never give up, inshallah ta'ala. Make it easy and never give up. The second advice I say to myself always when I'm in the program, that to be sincere to Al-Quran. As Rasulullah said, Ad-Dinu Nasiha, Qulna Liman Ya Rasulallah, قال لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين وعامتهم. You have to be sincere to Allah, to the book of Allah, to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to the Muslim rulers and to the common Muslims and all the Muslims. Sincerity is very important, and it is a secret of success and to get the fruit inshallah ta'ala in this life and hereafter. That's why we have to be sincere in our work, inshallah ta'ala. Even if we have difficult life or struggling, we have so much. Yeah, subhanAllah, if you ask about how busy am I, I'm so busy. I don't find that sometimes I don't find the time to eat. Sometimes my wife put the food and I eat it like after 5-3 hours. And she gave up right now. So even if we are so busy, we inshallah ta'ala, sincerity must be available and give time bi-iznillah ta'ala. Jazakumullah khair for the whole community. And I would like to congratulate all the brothers and sisters who finished memorization with us or with any masjid or any program in the valley, in the whole US, in the whole world. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our youth, and may Allah azza wa jalla put barakah in our children and make the new generation better than current and previous generations, and support and help our deen and give victory to the Islam and Muslims, and make the Islam rise more and more. Allahumma ameen. Brother Naqib, if you want to give some questions or if you have any point, inshallah.
Yeah, we asked. Okay, so brothers and sisters, if you have any question, please feel free to ask your question directly to our Sheikh. You can also type your question in the chat window. I will give you maybe one more minute. If we don't have any question, then inshallah Sheikh will lead the dua.
I would like also to remind all our attendees tonight that we have this program twice. We have this session on Zoom twice a week. We have it on Tuesday and Friday at 8 o'clock. I would like to encourage and recommend everyone to attend and give us your suggestion. We can have guests this weekend, invite people. Any program comes in your mind, because, you know, let's make this as the way how to meet each other, the way how to spend the time have mutual learning together until we get back to regular programs in the masjid, inshallah ta'ala. It is difficult not to meet the community, not to listen to each other, not to learn from each other, not to help each other. It's difficult time on everybody, I know, but at least, inshallah, keep in mind to attend this program, inshallah ta'ala, as much as you can. And you know, it is in Zoom. Even if you are busy doing something, okay, just to open it, and you might listen a benefit, you might get a benefit, one benefit, two benefits. You might have a question to ask, inshallah ta'ala. And it will be honor for me to join, inshallah ta'ala. And this will be very, very big honor for our masjid, inshallah, to keep you close and keep you attached to your beloved Islamic center of the East Valley.
Okay, JazakAllah khairan, Sheikh. So we received one question. Someone is asking, could you please give some advice on how to review what you have already memorized?
That's a very good question, because revision is very important. Without revision, the Quran will fly out of our mind, will go away quickly from our mind. And one of the righteous people was asked, why we forget the Quran? Why we forget the Quran? Then he said, because Al-Quran is a might book, Kitabun Aziz, and like an honor guest. And if you have a guest in your house and you do not make good hospitality to him, you do not welcome him, if you ignore him, he will leave you. Imagine about an honored person, noble person. Noble guest comes at your house and you ignore him, he will leave, because noble people will not like to be down. So same thing, the Quran is noble book, as Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَإِنَّهُ لَكِتَابٌ عَزِيزٌ لَا يَأْتِيهِ الْبَاطِلُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَلَا مِنْ خَلْفِهِ تَنْزِيلٌ مِنْ حَكِيمٍ حَمِيدٍ. And Allah said, وَإِنَّهُ فِي أُمِّ الْكِتَابِ لَدَيْنَا لَعَلِيٌّ حَكِيمٌ. Ali, you know, Ali is high and having the best qualities, the best description from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the book is Aziz. And he said that noble Quran will not stay in the heart of someone ignoring him, ignoring the Quran. So that's why we have to revise. So as much as we read and revise from the Quran will stay alive in our minds. The way how to revise the Quran, there are so many methods to use, inshallah ta'ala. And the general advice, or the advice you should take seriously, that to have some teacher to help you, especially if you are at the beginning of revision, like if you have new memorization. If you have new memorization, like a year or so, then you have to have a teacher. You have to have some teacher or imam or a person or father, mother, a person to help you, to listen to you and recite to him, and listen, he will listen to you and correct you. This is very, very important, because I have seen those who are dependent on their own, especially from the new Huffaz, they make a lot of mistakes while they are not aware of it. And these mistakes, unfortunately, will stay with them until they grow up, and maybe will not go away until they find someone to correct them. But if the Quran is old, the memorization is old, then you can do your own program, inshallah ta'ala. And the revision will be like memorization. You have small part or based on your ability. And you read it. When you read it from the Quran first. Like act if you did not memorize it before, especially if you are a new hafiz. When you come to revision, you have to act as if you did not memorize it before, even if you find it in your mind. How? You open the Quran and read it as new lesson. I read it so many times, okay, at least 5 times, at least minimum, okay. Then after that, you read it from your mind, your memory, okay, inshallah, and you have like have a page or one page. Then you repeat it a lot and make it to work in your mind the whole day. And next day you add another page, then you recite 2 pages. Okay, and next day you add the third page and recite 3 pages. And you keep going like this until you reach a big amount that you have no time or will be difficult to bring all of it one time. Then you make one stop, then second stop, third stop, fourth, fifth, and you can have 100 stops, okay? 100 parts, like make it, I usually prefer to make it juz by juz, like finish one juz and make sure you memorize it, you recite one ruba', which is 2 pages together, you know, from the market to the other mark, okay? It's called ruba'. The juz has 8 ruba', so you can have these 8 ruba' recite one by one. Okay, then after you finish the juz, make it first stop. Then go over the juz, it takes 3 days, 4 days, 1 week, and perfect it, make it good. Then leave it and go to the next juz. And start with the first ruba', recited page or half or 2 pages together until you finish the ruba', perfected, go over it, make sure you have this ruba' from sign to the sign. Okay, then go to next one, do same thing. After you finish the juz, this will be second stop. Then you go back over this juz and read it and read it again and again. The key of success in your revision, that to read it a lot from your memory, like about 50 times, 60 times. And that the time you recite when you are unaware or busy or not focusing, don't include it. Only include the times when you are focusing and devoting your time and being attention. In order to focus also, you have to choose a place you sit and the environment surrounding you. Usually the scholars say, do not sit next to noise, a lot of noises, especially for the new memorizers, okay, new huffaz. But if you are an old hafiz, you can do it even in the market. It's not a problem, inshallah. But for the new huffaz, you need to have a quiet time, like close the room or sit in a place you don't have much noise. Do as much as you can. And this will come as a habit, because you know some people, the noise is different from people to other people. And also they said, do not sit in a place have a lot of attractions, like people are playing or TV is on, or even water rivers or a place has a lot of trees and gardens, because this will attract your mind. Some scholars said, put your face to the wall. So put your face to the wall and make yourself that you cannot see your right side and your left side, your front side, your back side. You have only the wall, and plain wall has no picture. Then focus on that and read and read and read and recite. Finish your lesson or your revision or the part you appointed for yourself or your teacher appointed for you. Then you're done. You do this every time. And last advice, make sure you revise before you sleep. Before you sleep is very important time, because the memory will be working the whole night. And you might dream about the ayat you recited. And they talk about myself. Sometimes my wife used to wake me up and say, hey, you were reciting something. Or you were saying the khutbah or a speech in the when you are sleeping, okay? Because what you engage your mind with before you sleep, this will make it alive during the sleep, and this will be as an extra time extra time to perfect the Quran, inshallah ta'ala. Very, very important to revise before you sleep. And you know, if you memorize it, you can read it, like read one last page. You don't have to read the whole thing, unless if you have time, mashallah. But if you, before you sleep, just the last lesson, like one page, last page, or last quarter, or last ruba, you just recite it, okay, before you sleep. And if you sleep during your recitation, not a problem, but make sure this will be before you sleep, and this will give good time, inshallah, extra time when you are sleeping. Yeah, this is what I can give to this question for now, inshallah.
So there's another question. She's asking, when the kids are really young, they start memorizing some surahs or part of the Quran from their parents. So sometimes the tasveed may not be good when the kids are learning from their parents. So what should we do? Should we continue, let them memorizing the Quran, or how do we handle the situation?
Wallahi, this question, the answer is difficult for me, because I have some information and some experience. The informational answer is that help your children anytime as much as you can, they memorize as much as you can. Anything will benefit will help. But unfortunately, if I come to the experience, the students who learn wrong at early age, they give us hard time to correct their tongue. I have people reached now to the middle of the Quran, and they cannot pronounce the Quran correctly because the starting was wrong. And every and each lesson, I correct and try with them and take long time, but they still give the same mistakes. And the foundation, if the foundation is not sound and not in right way, it will bring a lot of it will make it difficult. So I can't say if the parents stop teaching your children, but the best advice is that hire a teacher or put him in the Quran program, put him in our Quran program early. Alhamdulillah, we have in the program, we have reading classes, and we accept the children from 5 years old. I think this is very nice. And also we used to have lower than in this age, even if people younger than 5 years old, then they can see it, they can listen, they can learn. Okay, we used to accept them, but now it is difficult to accept that age. But if you start with the right teacher and in right time, early, this will be better. Then the pronunciation, the letters will be sound. So then the foundation will be right. And also there is a problem about some parents, they think good about themselves, that they think they are well educated. Even some parents, they think they are better than Imam Ahmad Muharram at ICEV in recitation, or Imam so-and-so in the masjid, or the teacher reciting the word. They think they are better than them in recitation and teaching. Then when you listen to their children, you found that their reading and their way of recitation is horrible. So we have to be realistic, and we have to test ourselves. So I have two advice. Let's make it summarize two advices, okay? First advice is go ahead and start with your children. But can you test yourself? Go to a teacher or an imam and recite to him, and you can, and this by the way is very, very easy and perfect. You can call any teacher, any imam, and let him correct the surah for you. For sisters also, you can contact any sister and learn from them the surah you're gonna teach it to your child. In this way, inshallah, the mistakes will be limited and the foundation will be good. So this one advice, and you go ahead and start with your child when he's 3 years old or 3.5 years old early. Then once he has a or she has a chance to go to the program, put them in the program. The second advice, get a teacher early, okay? Even half an hour once a while, 1 hour once a while, to just check your work and check what you're doing. So he will correct the child and correct you too, or will help inshallah ta'ala. Also, there is a great point here you should pay attention to. Some kids are very smart. Like you say, inshallah, I'm going to start with this child and he will memorize and finish the Quran after 5 years. And you find this child finished in 2 years or less than 2 years. I know some of the children in the community here, and I advised their parents. They were very smart, and I see in their faces and I see in them that they can finish the Quran in 2 years. And they were like at that time, 4 years, or I remember one of them was 3.5 years old. But they did not take the advantage, okay? And their children would not be able to do well. And maybe they are struggling now and they are over 10 years old now. So take the advantage, and you never know if your child, mashallah, reaches that. Maybe you have certain time, some years in a plan in your mind, but you will find the surprises from your child. That's why make the foundation from the beginning correct, inshallah. Again, I don't want to stop the family from teaching their children. Go ahead and teach, but test yourself. And if you are able to get a teacher, this will be the best choice, inshallah. Jazakum Allah khair. Allahu a'lam. Allah knows the best.
Yaakum. The last question came. Sister is asking, what is the reward to become a Hafiz? And what is the reward for the parents?
The reward for the parents, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned in the hadith, that the Quran will intercede for them. And the Quran, the memorization of their child will intercede for them. And will not let them go except to Al-Jannah. And the Quran, the memorization of the Quran will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to honor the parents. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla will honor them, and Allah will put the crown on their head as honoring of their effort and the blessing from the memorization of the Quran from their child. So this one reward, okay, which is in al-akhirah. The second reward, that those parents struggled. You know, I know some parents, wallahi, they struggle. They correct every and each word with their children. And the children might scream and cry and give them hard time, but they were so nice and patient with them until the child will do his lesson or her lesson. Jazakum Allah khair. Very good. And inshallah, this effort will be as a reward in your balance. And this is a great reward. So you know that the reward is not after only, the reward at the time of the journey, from the day when you started, and that struggling will be counted for you as hasanat. And this is a great benefit, because the parents, one of them might die. And with that effort, will have so much reward he did with his children, inshallah ta'ala, or her children. So this, don't forget this part, that this journey is a blessed. That's why some parents say, no, I don't want my child to finish the Quran early. I want to struggle more with him or her. I want him to take more time because I will get more reward. Every time I think about memorization and I encourage him, I help him or her or continue with him or her, then this is a reward for me. Like I'm in salah, like I'm in salah the whole time, right? So this another benefit. There is another benefit, which is any letter your child will recite it. Okay, you will get reward, and you know the letter, how many hasana we get for the reciting one letter from the Quran? 10 hasana. So imagine your child is repeating, and sent to teacher, and teacher return him back and correct him, stop him or her, then all of this repetition in the Quran, repeating, will be as hasanat for you. Every and each time, 10 hasanat for each letter, you will get reward, okay, like your son reward or your daughter reward, without minimizing any of their reward. And this is a generosity from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then this reward will be endless, inshallah ta'ala, because after you die, your children alive, they will recite the Quran in their prayer, they will teach it to others. And if they teach it to another person, you get now the reward of your, now you get two rewards for your child recitation and also his students. Okay, so it's very, very beneficial the way how to, it's a smart way how to trade with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just to give time and effort, inshallah. This another benefit that the Quran will help your child to be a righteous person. So Allah will save him from a lot of misleading, a lot of bad manner, a lot of evil. Okay, and you know when parents see their child good and righteous, okay, they will be happy and they will be comfortable. So this like the parents are saving themselves from a lot of troubles, because you know when the child is not good, he might bring stress, he might destroy the mentality of their children, of their parents. Okay, some children, especially when they grow up and they are not nice and not good to their parents, and some of them are rude to their parents and not helping and not supporting them, not taking care of them. Okay, this is a distraction. This is a big problem for the family. So if when you help your children to memorize the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will appreciate that from you. And he will say, you are my servant. You helped your son to take care of my book, I'll take care of you. And Allah will make your children righteous, or at least they will not harm you, like someone that does not know anything about the Quran. It doesn't mean that whoever does not memorize the Quran is bad to his parents or will not benefit. No, I'm not saying that. But I'm saying he will be more qualified and have more teaching. And this actually, it is an advice for our memorizers, the Huffaz. So now you have a treasures and you have guidance to guide you how to treat your parents, okay, how to deal with them, how to take care of them, to be soft and to be nice and kind, to be hanoon and ra'uf, okay, to your parents, and have a very, very kind way to treat them and take care of them, respect them, listen to their advice, help them, and they show them and do for them what they like, what will make them happy, as long as not conflict and not conflict with the Islam. So inshallah ta'ala, this will be a great benefit for the parents, that this will be as helping their children to be righteous. Then this will help the parents themselves in their life, beside the other rewards. Yeah, we can talk the whole night, mashallah, about how much you benefit from your children. So, and you know, there is another benefit, which is reciting the Quran in your house. Okay, reciting the Quran from your children and your family. This will bring the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, some family, they might have one righteous person or one person obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And because of this person, Allah will send rahmah on the whole family, the whole relatives. Okay. Yeah, and subhanAllah, I have seen some parents, they don't deserve any good. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored them, and Allah protected them and gave them so much blessings because one person is a good person in their families or one child. So this also will be as a source of rahmah, mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially when you introduce to the ummah, to the Muslim ummah and the community, a person who will be like having Kitab Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and be able to like be a scholar, future scholar, to teach and help people to know and learn the book of Allah. As Rasulullah sallam said, khayrukum man ta'allama al-Qur'ana wa 'allamahu. The best one of you, the one who learned the Quran and teach it. Wallahu a'lam. Jazakum Allah khair for the question.
I think that was the last one, Sheikh. So please go ahead and lead the dua for us, inshallah.
We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our brother Muhammad. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless his family. We ask Allah azza wa jalla to make the Quran firm in his heart. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the Quran guide to make the Quran guidance, guide him to Al-Jannah, guide him to every good in this life and hereafter. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy on our children, our youth, to memorize the Quran and learn the Islam and stay firm in their deen. And we ask Allah to save us and save all the ummah from all the evil. Rabbana atina min ladunka rahmata wa hayy lana min amrina rashada. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanata wa fil akhirati hasanata wa qina azab an-nar. اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه ما لم نعلم ونسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد النبي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين وجزاكم الله خير الجزاء.